What you can see here is the R console. R is an open source statistical analysis program. What it allows you to do, and the functionality it will eventually get to, is to carry out complex statistical analyses for us. However, to demonstrate how it works and how you need to interface with it, we're going to show you the most basic way of using R. R uses a command line interface. What that essentially means is you type in a command, you hit enter, and then R prints out a response. So in this case, we asked R, what is the sum of 1 plus 1? And it let us know that it's 2. And this is how we'll demonstrate R's basic functionality, is to ask it these simple questions. What's 1 minus 1? What's 2 times 3? What is 5 divided by 6? What's 25 raised to the power of 25? So you can use R as a just simple basic calculator, although that's not really tapping what it can really do. You can use R to evaluate logical statements. Is 1 equal to 1? Yeah. Is 1 equal to 2? Not so much. And there are a whole host of logical operators you can use. Is 1 not equal to 2? Is 1 less than 2? Is 1 greater than 2? Is 5 greater than or equal to 5? Yeah, it is. Now, this is sort of the most basic way of doing it. To really get to the next level, we have to start using functions. We're going to use a very basic function, the square root function. All functions in R start with a string of text characters followed by parentheses. And then inside those parentheses, you type in an argument that helps tell R what to do. So for example, if we write square root with these parentheses and 150 inside, it returns the square root of 150. Now, this is the most sort of basic type of function that you could. Also, you can save values in R as R objects. Say we wanted to save a specific value. Say we wanted x to be equal to 3.14. Okay? And then we want to add a value to x to see what it comes out to be. So we can continue to use that basic math. We can continue to evaluate those logical statements. Now, you're not just limited to one value or one scalar point. You actually can get a whole vector or series of numbers. So if we wanted several numbers stored into a whole argument, so let's save this to our object named y, we'd want c. You can think of C as in C for combine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now we can actually save all five of those values. And if we wanted to see the value that we saved at any one point in time, all we have to do is type in the name of that R object, and R will print it out for us once we hit enter. Now, obviously, you're not going to want to keep the R console open forever. You would probably like to be able to save your work. Now, we can't save what's in the console per se, but we can save the values we assign to these different R objects. We have a nice little function for that. Save.image. And then we specify the file name we want in quotes with the extension RData. Now, this saves to a default location called the working directory. Now, on most PCs, this happens to be your documents folder, and you can find your working directory by using the function getwd. In this case, it's in my documents folder. If I wanted to see files in my working directory, There I go. So it looks like I got some stuff for some Arduinos. I got a couple files. And here we go. Data.rdata, the file we just saved. Now, R is really powerful. We can do a lot. And this command line interface is very flexible. And once you know the syntax, it's really nice and easy to use. However, for most people that don't have experience with coding and haven't exactly been running around using MS-DOS or the command line in their computer, it's actually a bit of a foreign environment. This is RStudio. RStudio is a second program that's free, or at least the base version of it is, that you can download, and it interacts with R, and it helps you. So, first thing you probably notice is that we still have that command line interface. That console is right there. However, there's some additional pieces of functionality. Right down here, we actually have a graphical representation of our working directory. Here's our file that we had earlier. So we can actually click it and import it. And look, there we can see x at 3.4. Y, which is a numeric vector with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We could still, of course, print them out in the console, but we can ask see them in this global environment. You could even back and see what code you've typed in the past. Also, this window right here, when we create a bar graph, it'll actually show us that bar graph right here. We can look up different packages that R has. Because R is open source, independent parties have gone and written additional code and sort of functionality for R. So for example, grammar of data manipulation is one we're definitely going to use. ggplot is another one that's really important and we're probably going to use as well. There's also help. So say I wanted to know about a function. Let's say I wanted to know more about the square root function. Here we go. These windows are movable. You can get a little description of it, and it will even go so far as to give you example code. Now, I will warn you, this does read a little bit like a technical manual, and it's not always the most user-friendly, but it's very, very handy and tells you what you need to know. Saving data in RStudio is also a little bit easier. We have this nice file, little floppy disk that we can use to save things. If we wanted to clear everything out, we could hit the sweep button, and if we wanted to open a different file, we even have an icon for that as well. Another really nice thing at RStudio, especially if you're just learning, is that RStudio gives you sort of code editing capacities and will give you suggested lines of code. So, for example, as I get typing, it will actually pull up a little suggested function based on what you've typed so far. So here, it's suggesting the square root code. It gives us a little bit of information about it, so on and so forth. And when you start naming R objects more and more complex names, like, say, we wanted the number of times as a variable, and we want couple values, it'll let us know. And it'll actually help us pull it up, and it'll actually save us some keystrokes as well.